Hey everyone, I wanted to do a special review on Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious from Kate Spade. Now these lipsticks were part of a collaboration with Poppy King, who is the iconic makeup artist, also known as the Lipstick Queen. So I think she sold several products, I think cosmetic products in her lifetime, and her most famous products were lipsticks, so that's why she's called Lipstick Queen. Normally, I do not wear any lip products on a daily basis. I don't wear lipstick, I don't wear lip gloss, I don't even wear chapstick, which is probably an issue when it comes wintertime when it becomes drier, and I'll probably fix that in the future. But regardless, I don't wear lip products that often, which means when I bought this, this is an amazing product. So how I came across this was when I went to a Kate Spade Fall Fête event. And my friend noticed these lipsticks that were at the Kate Spade counter. And it's kind of weird because I didn't expect Kate Spade to provide lipsticks. I usually know them as handbags or accessories or sometimes even clothes and shoes. So at first I didn't glance at them. They were really pretty. That's all I thought about. But my friend swatched it on her hand and I was really surprised at how beautiful these colors were. They were kind of sheer looking and they looked really moisturizing on her hand. So I decided why not, I should just try it on. Lo and behold, these are the most amazingly moisturizing lipsticks I've ever encountered. I've tried Revlon Color Burst lipsticks, I've tried Lancome lipsticks, I've tried YSL lipsticks, I've tried a bunch of lipsticks, and I just really didn't like the smell of them, like the chemical smell, the texture of them, how it might be drying afterwards, and you have to like scrub your lips after every once a week or so in order to like make your lips look smooth, and it was just such a big hassle. I just didn't really care for lipsticks in general. But the thing about these lipsticks that's so special is that they have shea butter in them, and apparently they are universally flattering, all these colors that they have in their collection. I have two of the colors. The first one that I have right here is Fuchsia Fête, and that's what I have on my lips right now. And like I said, it's a sheer application, but you can build it up, which is pretty awesome. My friend really likes bold colors, so what she did, wiped the lipstick on multiple times, and she got a pretty decent pigmentation. I prefer a more wearable look, so that's what attracted me to these lipsticks, because I found that it was a multi-purpose lipstick. It could be sheer and wearable, or it can be bold and more nighttime appropriate, or more, I guess, statement appropriate. So this is what the packaging looks like. I would come closer, but the camera doesn't autofocus. So it's like a nice, heavy-duty metal casing, and it says Supercalifragilistic, which I think the name is adorable. I love it. It was very clever of them to think of that. And then it says Kate Spade, New York. And how you open it, which is pretty important because I messed up my first lipstick this way. So you click it, and it pops out like that. And don't turn it because the lipstick will come out this way, and then it'll get mushed at the top. So just pull it straight out, and you twist it up, and it's lipstick. On the side, it also says pucker up, which I thought was really cute and fun and kind of surprising. And so, like I said, this is the Fuchsia Fête one. So this is like the fuchsia hot pink type one. But as you can tell on my lips, it's pretty wearable. It's kind of like a watermelon fuchsia pink, which I find that looks really good on my skin tone. I find that if it's too orange or too warm, it can look strange on my skin. But I find that pinks look good. So I'm going to stick with pinks. So this is one of my favorites. This is the non-ruined one, as you can tell. And I really, really like it. I can't say enough about how these lipsticks are amazing. We're out of stock of this in the store, so I had to order this online. But they have free shipping, so that was cool. And the first color I actually bought was Bashful Blush. So this is the same exact packaging, and then you click it, pull it out. And this one, I did turn it while it was still in the case, so sadly it's all mushed at the top, but hopefully if I use it more often, it'll be kind of hidden. So although this color looks really dark, it's actually very pretty. It comes off as like a blush medium pink. So it's almost similar to my lip color, except it adds like a special blush toned hint of color to my lips, which I really like. This is incredibly wearable. I actually like to call these lipsticks lip chapsticks because they're so moisturizing. So I really, really like these. Since one, they're moisturizing, they don't dry out my lips at all. They're wonderful packaging. And Kate Spade, I just love their brand so much. It's like really cute. So the finish on these lipsticks is not quite glossy, but not quite lipstick-like. It's kind of like a chapstick finish, if that makes any sense. So it's kind of like shiny, but not overtly shiny, like a lip gloss. But it's not like, it doesn't look thick. It looks very natural. And the best thing about this lipstick is that it sets after a while. So once you put it on, and I don't know how long you have to wait for it, but eventually it sets because I just applied this on, so I can't show you. But basically, you put it on and it sets after a while, and I've like kissed my hand before and it doesn't come off at all. So that's really amazing that they are long lasting and they're moisturizing and they're buildable. So it's kind of an all-around great lipstick. I feel like one of the biggest cons about these lipsticks is I believe they don't travel well. I know that when I ordered the second Bashful blush, it also got mushed. I was hoping for this one to be perfectly normal, but when I got it in the mail, it was actually sticking out like this, which meant it got pressed right here, and I was hoping it wouldn't get turned, and when I pulled it out, it in fact got turned, so it is very mushed on the top. But it's still a great product. I'm still going to use it anyways. But just to warn you that these do not travel well. It's just unfortunate that this has to be a press button. I thought it was a cute idea, but at the same time, I don't think it's quite practical for the modern day woman to have this in their purse. These are pretty, I don't know, big lipsticks. Here's an example of a Lancôme lipstick to the Kate Spade one. So the Kate Spade one packaging is pretty large. I don't know if they were wasteful with their packaging or not. Actually, let's see. So it seems like the Lancôme has more product, even though it's a smaller packaging. So I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know. That might be kind of wasteful for Kate Spade to do that. It also doesn't travel well, so yeah, that's unfortunate that it has poor packaging, but the product is amazing, so I would just focus on that fact. I really, really like these. I mean, the fact that I bought two of them of two different colors, ooh, the camera shifted, and I bought a backup of the Bashful blush. This was my absolute favorite color of the bunch. It's the most wearable, work-appropriate, everyday sort of lipstick that you can just go to. And so the fact that I bought a backup of it, the Bashful blush and the Fuchsia Fett one, is amazing. I can't say enough about this product again. I highly recommend checking these out. This is the first lipstick collection Kate Spade has ever had. So I think that's really special to them. And Kate Spade sells a lot of these because they are an awesome brand. The people there at the Kate Spade store, oh my gosh, they were so nice. Thank you, Courtney and Jordan, for showing us around and being our personal stylist at the Fall Fest event and telling us more about this collaboration with Poppy King. So I thought that was a really cool idea for them. And yeah, I think they run about $24 each. And I got them for 20% off because I was invited to this event. I think there might have been a 20% coupon out there. I'm not quite sure, but don't quote me. So try to find some deals online, but $24, this is a great lipstick regardless. I think it's worth buying. I've never spent so much on a lipstick before, actually any lip product. In general, I don't really spend that much on makeup anyways on one single product, but these are so amazing. Very moisturizing. That was like the key point. And good color payoff in terms of pigment. You can like build up the pigmentation or make it sheer. So yeah. Thank you for watching my video, and let me know if you do try the Kate Spade lipsticks, because I would love to hear what your feedback is. Thank you for tuning in.